Mathis. Welcome to Superintendent Gormley's first video, Eblast.
Now to Ms. Margaret Gibbons, Head Nurse of Multi Public Schools, on BMI information.
I'd like to take a few minutes to help you understand about BMI, or Body Mass Index. The Massachusetts Department of Public Health promulgated regulations for all school districts to implement a BMI screening in grades 1, 4, 7, and 10. This screening has been completed and the results will or have been sent home. The BMI number is based on a correlation between the height and weight of an individual. BMI is part of the profile that makes up a person's ideal weight or to identify if someone is underweight, overweight, or obese. In addition, information on diet, exercise, and healthy eating are included in the packet. These are the major contributors for a healthy weight. Please bring your BMI letter to your son or daughter's next physical exam. Use this as an opportunity to discuss with your provider the best ways to help your child maintain or achieve a healthy weight. This also demonstrates to your son or daughter that you, as parent or guardian, are in a partnership with them and that you can help each other commit to healthy choices as a family. As usual, if you have any questions or want to discuss the BMI letter that was sent home to you, please feel free to contact me at Milton High School. Thanks,
Ms. Gibbons. All BMI information can be found at miltonbs.org.
Good morning, Milton. My name is Caroline Joyce.
And I'm John Long.
Now to Jackie Morgan, our Director of Food Services.
Ms. Morgan has information on new nutrition laws.
Hi, I'm Jackie Morgan. I'm the Director of Food Services for the Milton Public Schools. And I just wanted to give you a brief summary of what's happening in the changes of school nutrition next year. The Massachusetts legislation has passed a new law regarding food available and provided to children in public schools. This law affects 30 minutes before school starts, all day of school, and 30 minutes after school. This book here explains everything about the new law. We're going to have this on the front page of the public schools website. And we're also going to have a quick snapshot of the bill to make it easier to understand. But what it's doing is it's changing foods available in schools to all students. It's basically allowing just water and 4 ounce juice to students. If food is going to be available, it'll have to be whole grains, low calorie. And it's asking basically to reduce like cupcakes and celebrations into nutritious foods, such as fruit, if food's going to be offered. So this is something that's really great. It's a great opportunity for all of us. It's going to help us reduce our childhood obesity in the state. So this law starts beginning of August, and it will be in all public schools in the state of Massachusetts. If you have any questions, I'm always here to help and answer, but all of this information will be posted on the website. Milton Schools, www.miltonps.org. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Ms. Morgan, and all the information can be found at miltonbs.org.
Our first guest this morning is Mr. Chris Meehan from Pearson Middle School. Hi folks, my name's Christopher Main. I'm the health teacher at Pierce Middle School, and one of the things I've done this year is I've taken some time to give questions to the students and let them ask whatever health questions they want. And what I'm going to do for you guys is just go over some of my favorites that I've answered this year. These are just questions that the students have submitted to me. I take the time in front of the class to answer them. So the first one that I'm going to talk about is a good one. It's one that I didn't know before I got the question. So a student asked me and I'm like, I don't know. So I went and looked it up, researched it a little bit, and came back the next day with the answer for the class. So one student asked me, why do we cry? I was like, that's a great question. So I realized crying's a natural part of life. Everybody, babies, teens, adults, we all cry for different reasons, happiness, sadness. But when I looked at the research, what I found is, first one, it's an emotional release. It's a sign that we need to release something, whether it be stress, fear, anger. So it's an emotional release. The second thing, this is the thing that I found the most interesting, it does have a biomedical purpose too, or biochemical purpose. And that's because when we cry, we actually release hormones and toxins that are in our body that help calm us down. So I thought that was pretty cool. And the third reason why is it's a signal to other human beings that we need help. Babies cry because they want attention or they're injured or other things like that. Adults cry for similar reasons. They're sad. They want comfort from somebody else. So I thought that was a great question. I thought that was one I would share. The next question is, what is the healthiest type of food? That's a tough question to answer because obviously you need to eat a wide variety of food. I can't just live off kale for the rest of my life. I need to eat a bunch of food. But if you want the most bang for your buck, you're going to want to go with vegetables. In particular, dark green vegetables like spinach, kale, arugula. Those are great vegetables to eat. Now I know it doesn't taste great all the time. It's not fun to just grab a handful of spinach and throw it in your mouth. So what I do, because I don't really like it either, I mix it in with other things. I make smoothies. I'll throw it in with some apples, some berries, and mix it in and hide the taste. And you get the same nutrients, but without having to eat those up all the time. And it's really, really nutritious. All right, next question. Does stretching before activity prevent injuries? Actually, no. They've actually done some research recently that shows that stretching, just static stretching before activity, doesn't really prevent pulled muscles at all. The more important thing that you need to do is you actually need to warm up. You need to get the blood flowing through the body, get the heart pumping, because you need blood to the muscles. And if you don't get blood to the muscles, that's when you get pulled muscles. That's when you get injuries. So stretching before activity isn't necessarily the most important thing. It's part of being prepared and preventing injuries, but you need to get blood flow through the body. That's the most important thing. It's also very important to stretch after activity as well. And the final one that I'll answer right now, actually I'll take two more, I got a couple on here. What's the most dangerous type of disease? For me, there's a lot of scary infectious disease out there. You got Ebola and HIV. Those are really, really dangerous diseases. But if we want to just talk about the most dangerous disease, it's heart disease. It's the number one killer in America. And the thing about heart disease, it's most of the time preventable. Exercise and proper diet can reduce your risk of contracting heart disease later in life. So for me, the most dangerous disease is heart disease. And the last one, it is this time of year, allergies. Why do we have allergies? Allergies, they're crazy, they're annoying, they're frustrating. You wake up, your eyes are watering, you're swollen, you got snot running down your nose. It's gross, it's frustrating, it's uncomfortable. The reason why we do that is because we have an immune system, and our immune system is actually pretty awesome. It does some cool things for us, but when foreign agents come into our body, such as pollen or dust or anything like that, sometimes our body perceives that as a threat. And they're like, oh my God, we need to sound the alarm, get everything out. So start the running nose, trying to push all the pollen out. Dust and pollen are not dangerous to us. They're not going to hurt us, but our body does perceive them as a danger. So that's why we have allergies. The great thing is we now have allergy medicine, Benadryl, Allegra, Zyrtec, all sorts of different things that help us prevent those symptoms that come from allergies. Thank you for your time. Thanks for listening. I'll try to answer some more health questions. That's one of my favorite things to do, and have a great day.
Thanks for that helpful information, Mr. Main. And now to Mr. Duchon from the CATS program.
I am Todd Ducharme. I'm with CATS, the Competitive Athlete Training Zone, and we have been partners with the Milton Public Schools now for close to 4 years. We've done a lot of really, really great programming within the schools, and really appreciative, especially as a father of three Milton Public School students, for the work that Mary Gormley and John Fallon do to constantly try to bring in creative programs into the schools for our students. Just a sample of some of the things that we've done over the years. Most recently, we are kicking off a sports performance training program for the high school athletes here in the town. We will be doing a summer-long program, as well as kicking one off at the beginning of each sports season. So giving our athletes a chance to train the way the pros train here, right here on campus at the high school. We have also done a morning, early morning program for our faculty here in the town. It's been a great way to get faculty who currently have a routine on their own where they come in, but we provide one of our coaches to help get their day started off the right way. It's been a fun way to get the day going, and had a lot of great feedback from the folks who have been taking part in that. One of our longest running programs is our recess program, probably the one that we have the most fun with. What we do is we provide one of our experienced coaches to the playgrounds at each of our elementary schools. It is a way for us to get, because it's so difficult to provide physical education time throughout the day and throughout the week, for a number of reasons. This is a way to really provide at least an additional 20 minutes of productive activity for our students. A way for them to release their energy. From a learning perspective, there's a lot of research now that shows the importance of exercise and activity on learning. So it gets them restarted, ready to attack the rest of the day. So that's one of the programs that we're really excited about and probably have the most fun with. Let's see, a couple of other things that we've done. We've worked from a professional development standpoint and working with faculty from K through 12 as well as our lunch aides. Because one of the things that CATS is very good at is, aside from the activity and the fitness and the sports performance training, in general, we're very good at creating a motivational environment, whether it's being motivated to be active and train. But we can also relate that to schoolwork as well. So taking a lot of the principles and teaching that we deliver to our coaches, we were able to deliver those to the faculty to use in their classroom as well. So again, a lot of great things that we're doing currently, a lot of great ideas that we have moving forward. But again, we're very appreciative for this partnership. It's an amazing partnership that we have between CATS and Milton Public Schools, and looking for great things to come. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mr. Ducharme.
Have a great day, Milton.
Good morning, Milton. Now to Mr. Caron with the bullying information.
Good morning. My name is Alan Caron, one of the vice principals here at Milton High School, and I have been working with the Bullying Prevention Advisory Committee for the past few years, otherwise known as BPAC, and it's been a busy year. This past year, we've reviewed and revised our bullying policy district-wide, worked with the school committee to do that. We have reviewed and revised our bullying prevention and intervention plan, which is part of the new bullying law. So every 2 years, the district goes through that process. And again, we use the Bullying Prevention Advisory Committee to do that. We have a 12-member committee, members from all six schools in the Milton Public Schools. We also, this past year, first ran our new bullying curriculum, which was developed by a team of teachers from around the district. And the curriculum is thematic, so everyone in Milton Public Schools was working with the same theme at the same time of year in all six schools, K-12, pre-K-12. We also saw the first full year of the implementation of our online bullying reporting mechanism. You go to our website, MiltonPS.org WELPS website, to report a bullying incident. There's an icon you just click on, and you go to an anonymous reporting form online, and that's been successfully implemented throughout the district. And finally, we have created a bullying prevention guide for parents, which will be distributed in the fall. And this is just for parents and guardians to have conversations with their children about bullying. I would say If you had 10 minutes to spend with your child on this guide, you would be bully-proofing your child, and it would be an excellent use of time. So I suggest in the fall you look forward to receiving this and set aside a few minutes to talk to your children. Thank you.
Thanks for the helpful information, Mr. Cron.
And now to Ms. Bagley-Jones from the school committee.
Hi, I'm Kristen Bagley-Jones, a member of the Milton School Committee and the parent of two children in Milton Public Schools. I wanted to talk today for a minute about the Health and Wellness Subcommittee of the Milton School Committee. Education is really about the whole child, meaning schools really need to focus on academic achievement and learning challenges, but also on the social, emotional, behavioral, psychological, and physical health of and well-being of each child. Our staff in Milton Public Schools do a great job of supporting this goal. The Health and Wellness Subcommittee strives to also support this goal. Some of the issues we have focused on the Health and Wellness Subcommittee include piloting a nutrition project in all grade 3 schools in Milton, sponsored by the Milton Food Services Department and the Milton Hospital. An initiation that will start this fall is providing all elementary teachers with the Great Body Shop. This is a well-known health curriculum that focuses on general physical health, emotional health, and social health of children in elementary schools. It's a wonderful curriculum. The Health and Wellness Committee also supported the bullying initiative based on the work led by Alan Crone and the Bullying Prevention Committee. We also initiated some substance abuse programming by collaborating with Dr. John Knight, who runs a substance abuse program at Children's Hospital and is also a Milton resident. Watch for the motivational speaker Chris Heron, a former Celtics player who became addicted and is now clean and sober and speaks to students and their parents about substance abuse. He will be coming to Milton High School in the fall. Finally, we supported the concept and need for more health educators in the Milton Public Schools because we want to help all students acquire knowledge of health issues and to increase their skills in dealing with the difficult choices kids face every single day. The takeaway message that I hope you have is that awareness of the social emotional issues facing this generation is a huge challenge. Prevention is key, and we need to align our resources in the Milton Public Schools to support these efforts. Finally, I'd like to thank the members of the subcommittee for their work, for their effort. We meet once a month on Fridays at 8 a.m., and they all show up and they all contribute. Mary Gormley and John Phelan, the assistant superintendent and superintendent. Rich Garino, an adjustment counselor at Milton High School. Steve Tracer, the athletic director at Milton High School. Margaret Gibbons, the head nurse. Jackie Morgan, the director of Milton Public Schools Food Services. Jason Buffard, Milton Hospital, who has been a wonderful addition to the committee. Todd Ducharme, another additional welcome member of the committee. He's a Glover parent and also the director of CATS and has helped us with some recess programming to help kids be more active at recess time. And finally, Vicki McCarthy, who was the former town youth counselor and has consented to stay on the committee. I thank you very much for your time, and I hope the importance of health and wellness for every child in the Milton Public Schools has come across to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bagley-Jones, for the update of the Health and Wellness Subcommittee.
Good morning, Milton. My name is Mandel Gary Roberson, and now to Superintendent Gormley.
I hope you've enjoyed what was and is a first for the Milton Public Schools, this video email blast. I want to take a moment to thank Milton High School teacher Sean Lopresti and all of the students who worked with Mr. Lopresti to create this video email blast, and to all the individuals who, rather than submitting their piece to the email blast, agreed to be on film. I want to thank you for watching today's Health and Wellness video email blast, and I hope that you found the information educational and helpful. To everyone who is watching this email blast, I wish you and your families a healthy, happy, and restful summer. Remember about summer reading all summer, and we'll see you at the end of August. Thank you.
don't listen.